Imagine you're someone walking into a grocery store and you see the bananas you wish to purchase being weighed like this. The scales currently show 1.6 kilograms, although it can be whatever unit of mass you choose. That's fine. Imagine a different one if you want. And the bananas cost £1 per kilogram, or one currency unit per mass unit. You get the idea. I really like this mass puzzle. It's a lot of fun. For a start, instead of having bananas for scale, it's got a scale for bananas. And what? 2005. Oh, what if I said, it's one banana, how much can it cost? $10. 2003! Oh my, whoa. My references are not fresh. This puzzle, however, much fresher. This was actually devised by my friend Rob Eastaway for a mass inspiration online show we were doing last week. This is a show where I host it, we get mass speakers to come along, it's aimed at high school students, and actually the teenagers watching the show can interact and answer questions, and we posed exactly this puzzle. And I've got the breakdown of what they sent in, not that you should use teenagers to get you the correct answer for anything, but 50.5% of them went for the 80p option, 37.3% went for £1.60, and 12.3% went for £3.20. So that's a split. That's half of them going for 80p, half going for the other options, of which, yeah, 37% went for £1.60. And we were like, that's interesting. They couldn't work it out. So after the show, Rob tweeted this puzzle, and then it genuinely went bananas. People were arguing, primarily they were arguing either £1.60 or 80p. And people were getting pretty passionate, which is why I thought it might be fun to do a video on it. I don't want to deprive you the joy of trying that puzzle though. So, I mean, you might have to pause the video to try it, but in video, I'm gonna give you a very, very short break. Oh, by the way, a little fun trick. I'm gonna show you how you can use a banana to tell when your time is up. Hey, your time's up. I hope you had a think through of the puzzle yourself. You probably fell into one of two different camps. Some people look at it and go, this is not very complicated. It's not like a ridiculous multi-pulley situation.
Snatch block. There you go.
In which case, we've only really got the bananas to worry about. And so you want to put yourself in the place of the bananas. Imagine being the bananas. What is that like? And it's worth dwelling on that, because everyone asks, how do bananas peel? But no one ever asks, how do the bananas feel? And the bananas are the only thing with mass in this situation, because the string, we assume that cannot stretch, has no mass, the pulley has no mass, no friction. The only thing gravity can be pulling down are the bananas, and so the logic dictates that is the reading we're getting on the scale, because that's the only gravity in the situation. The other camp are people who go, whoa, it is still a pulley, and pulleys are a little bit magical, and there's string on both sides. So the bananas are kind of double pulling the pulley, because there's tension in the string where the bananas are, and over on the other side where it's attached to the ground. And so you're actually getting twice the mass of the bananas showing up on the scales because of the double pulling, so you need to half it. And I could just show you all the tensions and try and show you the working out, but if looking at the arguments on Twitter taught me anything, people will not be easily convinced by that. I think the only true way we could convince people is by actually getting some bananas, doing this situation, and seeing what the bananas weigh. But to achieve that, we would need an engineer who has access to a lot of props.
In here, well, I've got quite a lot of stuff. I've got slinkies, I've got bricks, I've got bouncy balls, and I've even got Newton's cradle. Does that. I've got a collection of boomerangs, and I quite like throwing my boomerangs. They're not normal boomerangs, but they work really well indoors. Pretty neat. But what I wanted to show you was my bananas.
Yep, it's longtime friend of the Stand Up Mass channel and resident domesticated engineer Hugh Hunt from Cambridge University. And I asked Hugh very kindly if they could recreate this situation to see if that will convince people.
Well, I'm weighing some bananas here. They're the bananas. And according to the scales, they weigh 1.6 kilograms. Well, do they weigh 1.6 kilograms? There's a string here that goes around a pulley, and the pulley is anchored over there. What happens if I unhook the anchor and put the bananas, just hang the bananas directly from the scales? Well, look, they weigh 0.8 kilograms. Well, we've got to sort this out. I have a feeling the bananas actually weigh 0.8 kilograms. When I hook this over the pulley, well, what's happening here is that the weight from the bananas is pulling down on this string, but the pulley means that the tension on this string here is equal to the weight of the bananas. So the pulley's being pulled down by twice the weight of the bananas, which is exactly what we see up there, 1.6 kilograms. There we go, that's how you weigh bananas.
Yep, the correct answer was 80p. This is a nice static situation, nothing is moving, the tension is the same everywhere in the string, and so we know the bananas, because they're not moving, must have a tension holding them up equal to the gravity pulling them down. The tension must be the same on the other side of the pulley, so it is being double pulled. And that's the thing about pulleys, like even though it looks simple, they still give you weird mechanical advantages. I mean, I could have made a situation that looks a lot more complicated, like this.
Snatch block.
And in that case, you can if you want, you can try and step through how much would the scale show in this situation. But now you're kind of tipped off. You're like, eh, there's some weird pulleys going on here. So you know you're not just gonna get a simple reading off the scales. But even this, you know, the original setting, I quite like it, because it does get to the heart of using pulleys for mechanical advantage. Imagine instead of weighing the bananas on the scale, you're using this to lift the bananas up. So you're pulling where the scale should be. And that sounds like a silly idea. You're gonna have to put in twice as much force to do it that way compared to just picking the bananas up normally. However, you won't have to move as far. The pulley will move half the distance that the bananas will move. So you are still getting some advantage. And you're still putting in the same amount of work. And work is the force you're applying multiplied by the distance over which you're applying that force. Hey, it's me, the banana who feels, and I hate to banana split hairs, but I do banana feel we should be a bit more specific with our definition of work, because that equation only applies if the force you're applying is in the same direction as the direction the system is moving, and it's a nice linear constant force that doesn't vary during the movement. So nothing here can curve at all, which for me feels very unnatural. And don't be tempted to use the units Newton meters for work, partly because you confuse it with torque. And also, work should be measured in energy. You can do it in joules. Isn't that amazing? So make sure you're careful with your definition and units of work, or I will be very upset. We could also flip this situation up the other way, and this is the kind of mechanical advantage we normally see with pulleys. So now, what was the bananas being pulled down by gravity is you pulling up the rope, and now the scales are the mass, like the load that you're trying to shift. And this is the classic, you only have to put in half as much force as if you were lifting up the mass by itself, but you have to move twice as far. It's a trade-off. You can trade off the amount of force for the distance over which you have to apply it. And often you've got a situation where the force you can apply is capped, and so it's fine. You can compensate by just moving a greater distance than the actual thing you're trying to move. I hope that makes sense.
Snatch block! We're gonna snatch block this bad boy out of here.
And maybe you thought that first one weighing the bananas, a bit too straightforward. All right then. Hugh has also come up with this puzzle. So here we have a variety of masses currently held in place. The challenge is, when they're all released, first of all, are they gonna start moving? And specifically, if you look at that 30 gram mass on the side, you've gotta work out, will that mass accelerate up, accelerate down, or stay still with no acceleration. See if you can draw the sketch, see if you can work it through, decide what you think's gonna happen. And spoiler, I will bury deep in the description somewhere a link to a video where Hugh has actually set up these pulleys and done it, so you can convince yourself if you were right or wrong. Do check it out. There you are. In practical situations, pulleys can be super useful. Although I'll be honest, I think they're just as good if they're hypothetical pulleys in math problems that make you think. And we are doing more of those math inspiration shows. So if you are or know a teenager who would enjoy some more fun mathematics, the next one is tomorrow. So it's very soon. And that will feature Grant from 3 Blue, 1 Brown. And then after that, a couple of weeks, we've got the Christmas special. Details in the description and at the end of the video. I'm gonna leave you with some final thoughts from the banana who feels. Yep, me again, the banana who feels. And I, banana, feel, like I should mention, there's more than just Grant from 3 Blue, 1 Brown in the Maths Inspiration show tomorrow. There's also Simon Singh, incredible mathematics author. And we've got Eugenie von Tunzelman and Jen Rogers. Matt Parker, I was about to say me, not me, I'm the banana who feels. But I banana feel, like I should mention, Matt Parker is hosting that and the Christmas special. He'll be joined by Bobby Seagull and an incredible range of guests, including James Grime. I forget the name of James Grime's YouTube channel. You can look it up. And Hannah Fry. So what a show that's going to be. You can sign up to see these as a school, or you can just buy your own home household pass if you want to get involved. We'd really appreciate that. Help support the educational shows that I do, man, because this is a real serious educational outfit that I run here. It's probably a good time to say hello to all the people who subscribed to Stand Up Maths channel based on the last two videos, and they're here for in-depth data analysis of election results. Yep, this is welcome aboard. And finally, I banana feel like I should thank all the Patreon supporters who funded this incredible costume. And you know what? For Patreon exclusive content, I will film me wearing this costume eating a smaller banana. There you are. It's the kind of exclusive content you can get if you support this channel. So I just wanted to finish by saying, Patreon supporters, thanks a bunch. A bunch. I'm a banana.